The biggest news out of the Intel Developer Forum this year is Project Alloy, Intel's push into virtual and augmented reality. Project Alloy is a virtual reality headset that mixes elements of the real world. Intel is calling it mixed reality. It occupies a sort of middle ground between VR, which is entirely virtual, and augmented reality, which is mostly the real world with a few virtual elements attached.
Project Alloy takes the cord off the virtual reality headset.
With Alloy, Intel is following a tried and trusted model. The headset probably won't be available for sale as is. Instead, Intel is going to work on further refining it, and in 2017, its hardware blueprint will be published. That'll allow other companies to take that blueprint and then either produce it themselves or make further modifications to their own headsets. The hope is that it helps companies get into the market, and in turn means more sales and more demands for Intel chips.
At Intel, we think this is going to be big. And it's going to be a big driver of innovation because it's so different than anything else that's out there right now.
Now, Intel's not doing this on its own. It's also working with Microsoft, which demonstrated its Windows holographic system. And Microsoft has big plans for that software.
Next year, we will be releasing an update to all Windows 10 PCs that will include the Windows holographic shell. That means these Windows 10 PCs will be able to connect a head-mounted display and experience Windows holographic and run all of these Windows holographic applications.
Windows holographic will run on all levels of Windows 10 PCs, even small ones like the Intel Nook. But the two companies will also be pushing consumers to buy more powerful machines. That partnership has stumbled in the last couple of years as Intel lost out to ARM and Microsoft lost out to Android in the smartphone market. The virtual, mixed, and augmented reality deal is one way the two companies hope to get back on top.